join us, grab a room, we'll grab dinner, we'll hang out, gamble, whatever, trade. So definitely let me know if you're at all interested. We have a few people going now, and looking to have a good time. So definitely let me know if I can be of service. GSB in the house, how you doing, buddy? Happy afternoon. I know I don't usually go on in the afternoon, guys, but you know, gotta try new things, right? I've got an unboxing to do tonight. Right of first refusal is in effect. What's going on, Rube Dog? Hope you're having a good day too, man. Meals, yeah, I don't know about that. We'll see. You know, maybe you'll win a meal giveaway. Maybe we'll do a giveaway for a free meal. While we're there for other people, maybe one person will win a free meal or something like that. We will see. But definitely consider joining us at the Borgata December 8th and 9th. Definitely let me know if you have any interest in joining Collectors Weekend right here. Also, give me a follow, guys, on Instagram. Instagram is where I do most of my work. I got an update for today. But give me a follow on Instagram. Lots of new content all the time. We got toys. We got apparel. We got numismatics. So lots of different stuff. Games, of course. Big games, little games, mostly big games. So I do some education. Sometimes rare stuff like this is a trailer for Battlestar Galactica 1979 with letter from MCA Productions, and pretty damn cool in my opinion. So definitely give me a follow on the gram, on Instagram. Appreciate it if you would follow me on Instagram. You got 2 minutes, so go give me a follow on Instagram if you would. I hope everybody's doing well today. Welcome in. We've got a bunch of new stuff coming in, so we're gonna open and have some fun. I'll give you an idea. This is a real gold foil Trump, 999 gold foil Trump, given away. So if you don't want it, I guess don't enter. If you win, your shipping's free if you want anything. So where's my knife? Knife. So I got a bunch of new stuff in. Oh, thanks, Nixter. It's up your butt. Okay. I'll reach up there and grab it. Thanks. Did you really review? That's safe. Where are my reviews, damn it? Did I drop? Did I actually lose followers? Let's see. Reviews. Are you gonna leave a review? You can go check out my reviews if anybody's interested. There's a couple funny ones. Is K Dot here? Pants or donuts? Nice win. Thank you. K Dot left me one. Let's tag K Dot. Ben, you're here, right? I guess I should tag a few people. Promise Will Wait is a rating. Are you talking about? I don't know what that means. Ricky is probably busy, but you So I've got new stuff that just came in. It's been sitting around for a couple weeks because I don't have time to open it. So we're going to open it. Oh, I was reading your review, K-Dot. Sorry. Your review said that I was an asshole, but something else. What was my review? Mystery pack bid. So you want to bid on this? You want to bid on this before I open it? I honestly don't know what it is. He did. So this is a 82.1 to be specific on whatnot. Oh, you rated me. Okay, nice. I hope you rated me on my OnlyFans. Guys, follow my OnlyFans page. It's on Instagram. Follow my OnlyFans page on Instagram. Yes, my OnlyFeet. This is the, with the Domino's Pizza offer, this is a pizza tosser mic. These are super cool. Let me spin this for a second. I love these. And the thing about these is that because of the size of this bubble, see the size of this bubble right here? These never graded out well. And 80 is a really big grade on this, right? This is a really hard thing to get in a big grade. It's unpunched. It's beautiful. It's clear. They also yellowed. The plastic oxidized, and it turned yellow. So these are really, really hard to get in good grades. I had one that was a 70 or something, so I resubmitted it, and it's coming back a 95 for just the figure by itself. But I had to open it to do that, and so it's a loose complete now. This one at an 80, I mean, really, really cool. Let's see, the figure on this is 85. A card 80, bubble 85, figure 85. So really, really cool. It's a big one. It's a big boy. It's a big boy like my friend Antiquity Coins. So, you know, it's a big boy here. It's a big boy. Big boy. Did you said I could stream, right? Am I not allowed to stream? Didn't you say I could stream? Garrett now controls whether I stream or not. So, guys, if he says I can't stream, apparently I've got to get off. All right. He tells me when I can stream and when I can't stream. I don't know why. I don't know. Yeah, he's a socialist. Exactly. He's a socialist. Listen, I don't know why Garrett's turned into a socialist. I think it's the liberal agenda. He's very liberal. So I think he's turned into a socialist. But listen, we love him anyway. Listen, I, you know, as misguided as that might be, I really, he's a good guy. Off to only, it's actually only feet. I do only feet. So, next package. We still love him. He did a great stream last night. It was awkward at times, but we love him because of it. We love that for it. So, if you guys are not following Antiquity Coins, go give Antiquity Coins a follow. What other sellers are on here right now? GSB, if you're still here. GSB's not here, so don't follow GSB. No, it's gone. I'm just kidding. You can follow GSB. I think it's it, though. Money off fee, right? Why not? This is a super cool super mutant. You are here. It says you're not. It says you're gone. I did say to still follow you. Luckily, I followed up with that. No, I'm just kidding. GSB's a great seller. He's got so many cool toys. None of them are graded, or not many of them. He doesn't sell the graded ones anyway. But you can get them ungraded and play with them. So G will like it. This is an 85. 85 Super Mutants. This is so freaking cool. I'm geeking out because 85, 85, 85. This is such a nice Super Mutant Michelangelo. Really awesome. This is a series that came out in 1995. So kind of towards the, you know, towards the end of, you know, Turtles really went to 99 really. And then they started in 2003 or 2001. I forget, started again with Nickelodeon. But for the original quote unquote vintage line, this is towards, you know, this is about 4 years before the end. So closer to the end than the beginning. These are great, great figures and they're really undervalued. Then it went to crap, but you know, 2003 is going to become collectible in a few years. Just watch. So it's not a bad thing to get into. I love this one because the TMNT Super Mutants look, reminds me of Motu, reminds me of He-Man, and I really love that about this. So really cool figure here, and I'm really digging it. I love the gray, love the, you know, just a lot to love about this. So. Thundercats, yeah. So I've got Lion-O over there, and I've got him in the store. There. Oh, this is a nice one. This is a cool one too. I got so many big figures. I should have run this under Turtles. Let's run a Gibby. So we're opening collectibles right now. I honestly don't know what we're gonna open today, but I think it's mostly toys. That's why I ran under toys today. So action figures mostly probably, but I always run under action figures. So today we're gonna run under toys and hopefully appeal to a bigger crowd. But it's whatnot, so we expect very, very little return. In fact, we expect probably a negative day, but we do what we can. The glass, how are you, buddy? G was in here a few minutes ago, but I think he just came in to troll and then leave me. It would have been nice if he had stayed. You been better? What's wrong, buddy? Guys, Big Nate is such a great seller. I love Big Nate. Big Nate is the Glass 73. He runs a lot of foreign currency streams. Good guy. Really good guy. SD Retro for the... Dude, what a goat. SD Retro. I've ever, I'm going to pull a line out of Garrett's book. Have I ever told you how good looking you are? Oh, it's not in me. But no, SD Retro is a great streamer on here. Good friend and has some great games. If you want to play games, he's definitely a good one to go see. Love that SD Retro. Always try to stop into the homie's stream when he's on. I wish you ran overnight. I'd come and hang out with you every day. But that's true for like a lot of people. Oh, fuck. Look who just walked in. Look who walks. Not you, crazy. Hello, crazy, but it's not who I meant. The one with the big ears, the big floppy ears. Oh, stop it, crazy. I'm talking about the big moose. The big moose just walked in. You got moose balls. Moose balls in the house. Look at this guy, an 85. 85 on a wacky head spin and bebop. 85, 85, 90 subgrades. Let's check this out on the spinner. I am nice to crazy. What are you talking about? Why is everyone? Yeah, I wanted to go on early for you guys. Hey, you guys should get a chance to redline early. SD Retro in the house. Guys, tag Trollex in those guys, if you will. Guys, tag a bunch of people if you don't mind. Tag if you don't mind. And follow me on Instagram if you're new here. Instagram is what you guys can do to help me. Tagging or Instagram. If you can do either of those two things, I very much appreciate you today. 2,055 followers. I'm trying to get this up, guys. I'll really appreciate any help I can get in adding followers to my Instagram. It's where I do most of my business, so that's really where I need your help. If you guys can tag anybody you don't know or anybody I don't know, and maybe put them on to some of the stuff. I got tons of cool stuff. I got a Trey Dollar there. I got, you know, Itchy and Scratchy, all kinds of cool numismatics. So I appreciate everybody. Yeah, come see me for any interesting deals you want to get into. I got a newsletter probably coming out tonight. Appreciate everybody, you know, following and liking and everything else. I got a perfect copy of Tomb Raider Chronicles up for sale right now. Crazy price. Hit me up in the DM. Well, it turns into a shit show typically, Moose, but what are we going to do? We got to have some fun, right? Oh shit. I gotta go. Oh no. Where is it? This is a game from the person who just walked in there. MX. This is a graded piece of trash from one of my friends. Will he identify himself? Literally a piece of trash. He probably will not identify himself. It's doubtful. It's doubtful that he'll identify himself. But this is a piece of trash that's been graded. Actual trash. Certified trash. That's not the Givi. This is the Givi. You don't want the trash. This is gold. That's trash. The trash, you know? Yeah, it was on the trash. A napkin on the trash. If anybody's looking for some certified trash, I'll just leave this bad boy back here. Just leave that bad boy back there. Yeah, no problem, dude. If you want anything, your shipping's free, let me know. I'm happy to run some deals on shit, but I'm opening stuff today, so we're going to see some new stuff. I just opened this head-spinning Bebop right here. Buck and go? We don't do buck and go. What's this buck and go thing that I keep hearing about? Guys, if you can, let's boycott the buck and go so that smaller sellers can still afford to stream with you. If you guys keep robbing every small streamer on here, I don't do buck and go. That's what he's talking about. But if you guys keep robbing every streamer that's on here, there's going to be no small streamers, and all you're going to have is G's. And if all you have is G's, I mean, that's not going to be the same. I'm just telling you, that's why he's advocating this. He wants to get rid of all the small sellers. He wants them all gone because, yeah, he wants small sellers gone because he wants it to just be him. So he's advocating dollar starts for these people who are taking massive losses because he wants them gone. So do not buy into this rhetoric. This rhetoric of dollar starts for small sellers is going to collapse the small sellers. There'll be no small sellers on market on the platform anymore, right? You're retired because of buck and go. Exactly. Moose understands. So dollar starts tonight, maybe Silent Shredder. We'll see. Higher fees at dollar to go. Yeah, see, look, Antiquity Coin, while I love him, he's trying to do what's good for his business, which is to get rid of all the smaller sellers. And I love that about him. He's a shark. I love that about him. He's like Barbara Corcoran, you know, on Shark Tank. Like, he'll just go after you, you know, and it's great. She devoured all the small companies just like him. And it's amazing because, yeah, go big or go home. He already got rid of me. I had to retire because of him. Now I'm only allowed on the platform when he decides that I'm allowed on the platform. I had to text him first and say, hey, can I go live, please? please, can I go live today? And so he said yes. Ask for permission, exactly. Here's a sewer cycling raft. 85. Dude, fire today. Fire today. Absolute fire here. 85, 85, 90. Absolute fire coming out. This is an 85 from the sewer sports from 1992. Sewer cycling raft. Very, very nice. Open it. I can open it. I can open it for a price. I can open it for a price. Wait, listen, stop trying to get rid of my stream. That's all he's trying to do. And honestly, it's funny because he only comes in here when I got a Givi running. Like, if I don't do a Givi now, he's going to leave. And it's really funny because he got really mad last night when I won a Givi. Got really, really mad. And yet, like, he only comes in when he wants a Givi. I'm going to run another Givi for him so he'll stick around for 5 more minutes. How's that? How's that, buddy? This gold foil is for you. It's for you. Oh, shit, he's here. Hold on. I got to open this. What the fuck? These are expensive. Oh my god, they tear? Oh, these must have cost a lot. See, look, certain people that will remain nameless spend a lot of money on their bags. Now, that's concerning because the more money you spend on your bags, the more money you're taking from your customers. What's this? I'm surprised this didn't get bent, to be honest with you. That's amazing this didn't get bent. Hold on. I'm going to do this the right way. What was free? What was free? The shipping? You got the bags for free. How do you get the bags for free? I don't get that. How'd you get the bags for free? Guys, just stick around. This is cool. I was hoping you'd stop by so I could do this. It just came in yesterday. Oh, bitter, just in time. Dear Dave, I've been so busy with golf. With golf and quail. Not successful, not at all. And bridge, that I find I did not acknowledge either of your notes on the ninth. As to your political analysis, I am in complete accord. More importantly, Mamie and I were delighted that as soon as you get over being the father of the bride, you will make definite plans for our El Dorado visit. Now the new little radios have arrived. This time down here, I have had to depend more than ever upon the good offices of the people around the club, and I assure you they will make wonderful thank you presents. As always and perennially, I am deeply indebted to you. I haven't forgotten the extent of my monetary indebtedness either, and as soon as I get back to Gettysburg, I will send you a check to cover my bad political judgment. With warm regard, as ever, Mr. David Marks, 2205th Avenue, New York, New York. Which is cool because I also lived in New York, New York. So I guess this is actually G's subtle way of telling me that I'm a Marxist. He's calling me David Marxist because I live in New York, New York, but he's like referring to me as a Marxist. It's a troll that he went back in time to 1961. He went back in time to 1961. Not the giveaway. This is the giveaway. G-Man. Nice win. So as G knows, I paid quite a bit for this. I paid about $1,000. It was about $1,100. It was about $1,100. Really, really great purchase. I'm super happy with it. And you know, it was a really nice thing for G to sell to me. He makes a lot of money off this stuff, but like, it was a really nice thing, and I appreciate it very much. Even at the price that he charged me, it was still a good deal. I mean, it was expensive. It was really expensive. It was about $1,100. About $1,100. $1,500. That's, oh, you were there, right? $1,500. That's right. Yeah, about $1,500. So I don't know why he's trying to tell everybody I got it for free, but you know, I appreciate him nonetheless. You know, it's probably cost me. Realistically, it's probably cost me about $20,000. It probably cost me about $20,000 to be friends with you. Oh, no. In all honesty, he gave it to me as a god. It was an amazing gift. I appreciate him as a friend and a mentor. We love antiquity coins. Guys, follow him and troll him with me because we love that for him. Yeah, you're like my mentor, right? You decide when I'm allowed to stream. I'm not allowed to stream if you say no. Master, Sensei Garrett. Now, Steve, VT, you know, listen, I hate seeing shit go low on your stream. I know you don't care, and you're going to say you don't care, but you do care, and I hate to see it, all right? That's one. It does not make sense. It never makes sense for gold to go under melt value. You can literally ship it for the same price, so that is the market value. If you subscribe to capitalism, that is the market price that you should, the bare minimum market price that you should start at. And it makes no sense for the seller to get screwed. It makes no sense. Now, if you want to do a giveaway and you're big and you got tons of power, fine. You got lots of inventory, you're going to call it a write-off, whatever. But for a smaller seller, you can't expect them to do that. And that's how you got, you know, I mean, look at all the giveaways that you did to get you to where you are. A smaller seller can't afford to do that where you get. Now, that gives you power, that's fine. But like, don't rub it in other people's faces that they don't have as much power as you do. Like, let them have a chance to start off. That's the opposite of capitalism. That's communism. So, listen, all I want you to do is not be a communist. That's ultimately what I want for you. I want to teach you this. And listen, you're young. You're not young. All right, you're not young. You're old. But you're not – I'm older. I can admit it. I'm older. And you just – you haven't learned yet. And that's fine. You can be my mentor in certain ways. And I can be your mentor in, like, most ways. Like, it's totally cool. Like, my class is going to cost more than yours. But, like, listen, it's a net win for me. And that's okay. I'm okay with that. Net win for me, and I'm okay. All right. So, hey, Jen. This is my new Rocksteady. This is super sexy. Look at this guy. Flip top Rocksteady. What grade did this guy get? What grade did this thing get? 80 plus on this bad boy. 80 plus on this bad boy. Figure is a 90. Windows an 85. And box is an 80. This is a mutating Rocksteady. Really cool. From 1992 on the mutations. I've got a couple others of these. This is the giveaway, by the way. I don't know why he doesn't play with these toys. I mean, you know, I've got other toys to play with. Devam, nice win. Nice win. I got a new thing I do. Took an idea from my buddies So that's the givey. No, it's the right givey. It's the right givey. I'll explain along the way. Yeah, exactly. There's no buyers. There's nobody bought anything. So there's nobody there. There should be no entries into this. You ever gone hunting and you wanted to, like, you know, catch something or whatever, you lay a trap. That makes sense. You're trying to catch something. This is an 85, 86.9, 85, 85, 90. This is a nice Don the Undercover. Really nice. Really high grade. 86.9 on the Don. Let's put it up here with the auto mutations. These both just came in right now. That's my trash at the back you keep seeing. I might have just got him, Aztec. Neither do I. Amber, that is the appropriate response, Amber. You are always welcome here, Amber. Amber is my new favorite person. That is the appropriate response. I don't even know how to fill out the form. I blocked somebody who won. There was a form filler who won an Envy Coins stream earlier, and I blocked them. They won the first one. I've never even tried. Exactly. Correct. Because you either follow the rules or you're trying to scam somebody. Like, anybody who fills out the form is essentially trying to scam somebody. Like, Pudis, don't make me send you something, please. Listen, so Fish does it. I don't think Fish is here. Fish does it all the time. He's the only person I know who knows how to do it. I And Envy Coin was trying to be political and say, like, oh, sometimes they buy stuff, but, like, they never do. I've never seen that happen. I've never seen someone who filled out a form buy anything afterwards. Never. You did? You filled out a – but were you trolling the seller? Like, were you actually, you know – like, was it just a big troll? Okay. So, all right. All right. Well, maybe I stand corrected then. Oh, you're joking. Okay. I'm like, all right, well, I just got proven wrong, because Aztec's actually a good buyer. And if you did it, I would be like, oh, well, then I just literally got proven wrong. And maybe this whole theory is a bad idea, and I'm shooting myself in the foot. But you know what? I'm kind of like willing to take the gamble, you know? I'm kind of willing to take the gamble. Are you gonna bet? Will you continue that? If you'll bet that, then you have then you're gonna have a ton of people filling out that form. Crazy. So, I agree, Dave's collection. I and so thus my little experiment here. You better be able to back that up. Oh my God! I'm hoping one of them's. Pudis must have done it. That, by the way, the giveaway is a... oh, G probably just figured it out. The giveaway is a Trump foil. I don't care if one of my friends wins either. You still get a giveaway of a Trump foil. Oh, you got it? You got in, VT? Crash test dummies. Crash cannon. How cool is this? You put the figure in here and you blast one of them out? Oh, you were the first one. Oh, nice. 85. 87.1. Crash test dummies. You know, VT, you could have just bought something to get in. Instead of, I love how all of my friends are like, oh my God. He's always taking my money. Always. Always taking my money. Unreal. I might give you a t-shirt, but you suck. You fucking suck. You suck, suck, suck. But tell me what t-shirt you want. Fucking asshole. Oh, if you weren't buying me a vacation house, I'd be pretty upset right now. I do hope you guys will come to the collector's weekend. Maybe G will come to collector's weekend. G, you want to come to the collector's weekend? I'm busy that weekend. I know, dude. I know. I'm busy that weekend. Oh, thanks, G. I'm so glad you could come. I have to wash my hair that day. You're so right, Buddhist. I've got this hemorrhoid that I'm going to be dealing with that day. All right, Garrett. We love you. It's all right. It's all right. I'll cry in my room later. Oh, okay. I got a bunch of boxes to open. I'll show you. So I got those. And I got those, I think. And I think there's two over there. I don't know. I think that's it. But there might be one behind me, too. So let's just think plugged in. All right. So let's open at least one or two of them. I did want to get those. So that was the last of my CAS shipment. You're here, you can't hear? Is she trolling me? Can you guys hear me? So it's a great troll if she can't hear me. I love that for us. Probably not, no. Just the just the let's not break anything. Just the lino. I'm honestly not hunting for I've got one other mini one somewhere, but it's like a, if you're interested, I've got a mini Thundercat. It's an older one. It's definitely vintage. It's an older mini on card. I forget which character, but it would be like $125 to $150. Blackback? What do you mean? What, 85? Oh, you're looking for 85. Oh, yeah. I mean, dude. So am I. If I had an 85 to sell you, you know how expensive it would be? It would... I've got people I could sell it to in an instant for five figures. In an instant. So, the only person I know who's got 85s in them paid five figures for theirs. Yeah, this is cool. Yeah, I mean, it's awesome, but you're talking about some big money for the, especially, not all the variants of Lino, but like there's definitely some of them that'll run you five figures for, if you want to get all four of them. You have three? How much? You probably got them a while ago, but they're expensive right now. Do you know Peter? He's got all four, but I know he's not looking to sell. He told me he paid a significant amount for him. That was a couple of years ago too. That was at least a year ago, maybe two. I don't know. My sense of time is warped, but they're hard. They're hard to get. And people who have 85s don't want to let them go. You know. Are you looking to sell them? I mean, I can sell them for you if you're looking to sell them. I mean, I can get you a good price for them if you're looking to sell them. I got people that want them, but again, you know, getting an 85 is okay. Yeah. See, that's usually the problem, right? I know people who have them, but no, all of them would be buying them, not selling them. And I got people who I could instantly sell them to if you wanted to sell, but nobody wants to sell. I mean, I just don't ever see anybody. And there's also, like, if you are to find an 85, it's also likely that you get one yellow. And no one wants the yellow ones. So, I mean, I don't want the yellow ones. Sorry, I don't want the yellow ones. This is a cool one. This is a deluxe set. This is actually, like, impossible to find this particular character. So really hard one to find. And it's an uncirculated 85 from AFA. 90, 80, 90. So, pretty cool. What's BNG? What's BNG? G wants Beanie Babies. Bucking go what? Bucking go what? What do you want me to bucking go? What should I pay for this? Here, we'll call it a giveaway. All right, it's a giveaway. It's Kevin Eastman signed Ray Filet. It's a giveaway, guys. Anyone bid? It's a with COA. Kevin Eastman autographed it. Unpunched, mint condition. Consider it a giveaway. I guess Aztec's going to take it home for $1. Great. Giveaway, guys. Get in there. Get in the giveaway. Just swipe right for the giveaway. Swipe right for the giveaway. Aztec, you might as well take it home for $6, dude. I mean, I'd be happier to give it to you. Silent Shredder, thank you. I'll get to Silent Shredder. I mean, I'm not up to my cost yet. happy to give it to Silent Shredder. I mean, it costs $25 to get an autograph. Just saying. It costs $25 just to get him to autograph it, maybe 50 now. So if you take this, if you buy the toy at the store for $15 to $25 and you take that to the to get it signed, it's going to be a minimum of $50 to $60 right there. And then you got time and everything else. So, you know, $16. This was to prove to my friend G that Bucking O just hurts people. It hurts little sellers. So thank you for proving my point. You just hurt, you know, you just hurt me. So thank you. You're supposed to be my friend, but I appreciate that. Friend. Man, dude, if I have friends like that, I don't know if I need enemies anymore. Fucking go my ass. Fucking go. With friends like that, you didn't even bid. You didn't even bid. You asked me to run it, and then you didn't bid. What do you say on your streams? You say the thing you hate the most is when someone says to buck and go, and then they don't bid. You like it when people ask for stuff, and then they win it. You didn't even win it. I had Silent Shredder win it at $16. I'm happy to give it to Silent Shredder. I'm happy to give it to Silent Shredder, but you didn't ask. No one asked. I mean, I assume that you know that something with a signature goes for more than $16. You're not helping. You're hurting. You're hurting everyone, G. That's what I'm trying to explain to you. Listen, do you, and do what you want to do, but you're hurting everyone else. Listen, I appreciate that. These are two separate things. I can appreciate you and what you do and what you bring to the table without wanting you to hurt the little sellers. I can have respect and admiration for you and disagree with your stance at the same time and still care about you, still be my friend. But I think you're just wrong. You're hurting people. Don't touch me there. Don't touch me there. He did grab my Woody. There's a sign, Donatello. Okay, touch me there. There's a sign, April. Kevin Eastman, the creator of Turtles. Kevin Eastman and Peter Laird are the co-creators of TMNT. All the comics, everything. The new line is Kevin Eastman has done the new line of Last Ronin that just came out. The real turtle signed it. Kevin Eastman and has teamed up with some other people, some artists and other graphic novelists to create the Last Ronin, which just came out within the last year. And the Last Ronin is basically Michelangelo has survived his three brothers getting killed. And he is now the Last Ronin. And so it's, Casey Jones is in it. And without Kevin Eastman, there'd be no TMNT. So the Last Ronin is a darker, more graphic novel than like the comics before it. But it's a great way to continue the storyline and provide for a lot. There's going to be the Last Ronin is going to be a franchise. It's going to really, it's going to expand. It's going to be like a Star Wars thing. It in itself is going to grow and just morph over the years. You will have many, many stories spawn off of The Last Ronin because it's a continuation of this thing that everybody really loves, which will also continue and kind of morph in different ways. But you'll definitely have the, after the game, then comes the movies. Yeah. And you'll have games, you'll have merchandise. Like, there's a lot to be had because the thing is, they know it makes money. They know people want it. And that, you know, these guys are legends. Like, what they touch turns into gold. So there's a lot of value coming up. There's a lot of value propositions
in Turtle Land right now, and you definitely want to get a mixture of some of the roots and some of the new origins as well. So definitely don't ignore The Last Ronin. Agnes Skinner, Seymour's mom, AFA 80, really cool figure. I love all the Simpsons stuff, so I've been digging. I had a bunch of these come in. I've been digging them. I've started listing them on eBay, and we're going to be listing more. Yeah, sure. What would you like to know, Alpha? The question was, can you talk about your Pawn Stars experiences? All right, so the first time, I've been out there twice. So I can explain that too. How bad did they lowball you? So I went out twice and I did a total of 4 episodes. As far as I know, the 4th one is not aired, but like it took me a month last time to find out that my 3rd episode had aired. So I don't know exactly what the I don't know exactly when the 4th episode is going to air. You can't say Corey. Did they sell me drugs? No, in a glass. So I went out there twice, and each day I filmed 2 episodes while I was out there. The first day was like in 2019? And I filmed the first episode was Atari games, and I did this in January of 2020, January 2020, before the first Heritage auction with Atari games was May of 2020. So 4 months earlier, I took 2 games that were graded by 2 Atari games, Raiders of the Lost Ark and Frogger, that were graded by AFA. VGA, and I took those out. They cracked them out of the case there, and Dennis actually from WADA came in as the expert and examined them, gave them great, you know, high grades on the spot, which was easy because VGA had already graded them. But they examined them and they made me a really low ball offer. I think they passed on them. They cracked them, yeah. So, you know, yeah. They resubmitted them. WADA took them and resubmitted them with them and whatever. But because I guess they wanted to see them raw as opposed to already having been graded. So, you know, whatever works best for the storyline. So, but I mean, they were still the same games. So it wasn't, since I was getting them regraded for free, I didn't really care. So I don't think they made an offer on those, or if they did, it was like, I think I wanted, I don't even remember what I wanted, but they, 4 months later after I filmed it, the Atari auction happened and Atari went crazy, like huge prices on it. And so, you know, I ended up selling them for more than what they offered me for sure. But, you know, whatever. That episode, the entire episode was called Raiders of the Lost Pawn. And it was, you can Google it, you can look it up on YouTube or whatever. The second episode that day was Maximum Carnage. So I took one of the Maximum Carnage sets, the QVC sets, and it was ungraded, and I took it on and offered it. And they actually... No, that was the 3rd episode. I'm sorry. That was the 3rd episode. The 2nd episode was the M82 unit. The M82 unit was my favorite episode because it's a 12 cartridge kiosk changer. So you would put 12 NES games in it, and it was only for stores. NES stores had this, and they put 12 games in there, And no NDA. They wouldn't let me wear my logo. They wouldn't let me wear my logo on, so whatever. But you put 12 games in it, and because they couldn't do licensed games on TV because there's all kinds of, whatever, they used Chum Lee's homebrew. Chum Lee was developing a homebrew, and they used Chum Lee's homebrew in it, and they played that, and it was cool. It was a really great episode. I really liked making that one. The third one was really fun, but the way they edited it made me look like I was like paranoid or something. So I didn't love the third episode. It's my least favorite of the three. I am hoping that the fourth one that comes out is going to be cool, but the fourth one is I don't think it's out yet. So there should be another one. The item that they offer, the item in the fourth one, was the Nintendo with the Mario game that was graded by CAS. It was before it was graded, and I don't remember what they offered for it, but it ultimately sold for over $50,000 recently. So I did well in not selling it. Why do they do this? But they usually, the maximum carnage they actually offered me a pretty decent, and I should have taken it. But the market was high when they offered it to me. They lowballed me at the market. But given that I didn't sell it right at that time, the market rode down on it, and I should have taken their offer. But I do want to go back this year. I'm hoping to go back. But we'll see. We'll see. This is Lando Skiffgard from 2004, and it's a Hasbro uncirculated 85. Uncirculated means it came straight from a shipper crate, straight from the factory. So this never saw a shelf, meaning that it was uncirculated. So this is a cool item and a nice grade for a nice Lando 2004. But yeah, it was a fun time, and honestly, I would do it again for sure. Yeah, so I met him a couple times, and then my buddy knows him. So I went back to Vegas last year, and he actually came out to dinner with another friend or two. And we talked about this. It's like a Magic the Gathering type of game, but he plays a lot of like fantasy card games, like Magic the Gathering. And I want to say it was Krypton or something he was talking about. And he gave me a couple packs, and it was pretty cool. So. Yeah, I don't necessarily. Oh, thank you, Crazy. I don't necessarily, play that stuff, but he's so passionate about it. It was really cool to hear from him. So, this is one of my favorites. I love the Stormtroopers and the original card look on this. This is the This is the original trilogy Scout Trooper re-release in 2004. In 2004, another uncirculated figure. Really high subgrades, and a really cool overall piece right here. Dungeons & Dragons. You know, I played Dungeons & Dragons, and I did not have the greatest time with it. But, I'm also kind of like, that kind of hyperactive. Like, it's a little slow for me. So, it depends, but a lot of people like it. I worked with a couple people at a bank, at one of the banks I worked at, and they were really into it, so I went and tried it with them, and it wasn't bad, but it just wasn't what I want. It wasn't for me, but I have a lot of friends. I have some friends, anyway, that are into that. Here's a Wookiee. I don't know this particular Wookiee, but it's a Wookiee, and it's a 90. So 2005 Hasbro... Yarrow? I don't know. Pretty cool item, though. 90, and I love the original card backs. Oh, crazy. Thank you. Where did I put it? I'm so confused. I had ordered it canceled. I was open. Thank you, crazy. Are you coming to Collector's Weekend? This is a mask toy from 1987. Oh, thank you, Big Nate. Are you coming to the Collector's Weekend? We can share a room, Big Nate, if you know what I mean. It might be hot in there and there's no air conditioning, but it's okay. I have a nice rooster coin. That's right. 1987 Kenner mask. This is the Bullet the Racing Series with Ollie Bombay. I'm sure that the liberals would have some kind of problem with his name being Ollie Bombay, but this shit was a fun toy. So 1987, really cool. Oh, because the other one. I forgot I had to open this. You reminded me. Listen, I'm going to be... Yeah, squirrel. I'm going to be listing stuff tonight. If anybody wants anything before I list it, please let me know now. I'll work with you. Payment plans available. I want to get some stuff sold, so I'm going to be listing stuff and working tonight and looking to make some deals right now. So, yeah, I love Mask. I think the toys are still undervalued because there's a really passionate following for Mask that hasn't even realized that it's there. Like, people who love Mask that just don't even realize that the toys are being graded and exist, and like, it's going to hit hard for a lot of people. I think, you know, over the next 10 to 20 years, you're going to see a lot of people from my generation continue to increase in wealth and disposable income as their kids go off to college and they, you know, enter retirement age and stuff like that, the golden years. You know, for some people, obviously not everybody, but the people who have money are going to enter that age, and they're going to have more discretionary income, and they look to spend it on collectibles at times. So I think you're going to see Mask and certain things really continue to go up in value. You know, adult toy collecting, and not adult toys, but toy collecting for adults has increased drastically over the last, you know, couple of years. So, you know, obviously toy video games as well. And not adult toys, but adults who collect toys. I wonder if I can, you know what, let me see if this works again. I want to see if something works. I turned on my cellar tools. What's up, Coin Crate? How you doing, bro? Let me see if this works. I got Zoom. Look at that. I got Zoom, crazy. Oh, I got Zoom. Yo, look what I can do now. Look at that. Now you can see my statues. My iPad, but I turned on cellar tools. Apparently I had it turned off and I didn't realize it. So I turned on cellar tools and it allows me to Zoom now. So, yeah, I didn't know that. I do trades, I do payment plans, and I do trades. So on a payment plan, it's basically like layaway. You tell me you want something, we negotiate a price, you put a deposit down, the game or a toy or whatever is now yours. When you pay it off, I ship it. I don't bother you, I don't hassle you. You pay it off when you want to. And it's the easiest way to buy a collectible. If there's anything nice that you want, this is the easiest way to get into something. And the least amount of like hassle and the most amount of flexibility. So the crash should be around $600. Like whatnot price, fucking whatnotters, you know, it should be around 400, say 350. Whatnot should be asking me what, Timmy? Interested in Graded Devil's Third on Wii U. I don't know that game, but I'll take a look. I'm not saying no. I mean, if I can sell it to somebody else or trade it to somebody else, I'm happy to, you know, basically be a middleman. So if it works for me, I'll let you know. But the best way is to hit me on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram and send me a DM. What'd you say, Buddhist? Oh, Whatnot should be asking me how to sell. Thank you, Timmy. This is a cool one. This is an R2-D2. Look at this shit. Look at that R2-D2. I'm gonna reverse this. So crazy. If you wanted to buy it on here, I'd run it for you for $325 for you. I mean, it should be a minimum of $350, but you know, if you want me to run it, I will. Oh, am I still zoomed? There we go. Oh my God. That's crazy. I can't believe I can zoom now. So look, I can zoom. Look at that. Look at how cool that is. Right? Well, I got this iPad and I paid a lot of money for this iPad Pro and then I couldn't zoom and I'm like, what the fuck did I just pay for all this? I bought this like device because Whatnot told me that like, oh, I can do all this cool stuff if you have an Apple product. Here, I'll show you. All right, so this is us right now. This is right now. I'm using my iPad Pro. It's so weird looking at the perspective like that, right? But the iPad Pro, and then if I move it to the side, right? I move the chat to the side. Now I can zoom in, right? That's pretty cool. I have not been able to do that, so I'm very happy with that added functionality. So, yeah. So if you get an, you can do it on the iPhone natively. If you get the iPad and you turn on seller tools, it will now allow you to do that. So for any of you sellers out there who are looking to Is G still here? VT just said G wanted to buy something from me. He just let that thing go for like. Oh, he's been trolling me so hard on this communist thing now. So I didn't. Oh, let me see if I. So I've got a stand. You should get a stand. No matter what you do, you should get a stand. I got a bunch of them. I have like six stands. I mean, if you don't have a stand, you can't do anything. You got to have a stand. These are like 10, 15. I'll see you in January, but not December, huh? You can't go in December. That's too bad. December is going to be fun, but honestly, crazy. If you went in December, I'd go to the spa with you. I mean, you don't actually go together, but you know, I would be. I definitely wouldn't mind going to get a massage and like having a little R&R. But Yeah, it'll be cool. I hope VT comes out. It'll be amazing if you do, VT. So this is a cool toy. This is 2005 Hasbro. This is basically about to be vintage in a couple years. We're a year and a half away from this being vintage as well, I guess, based on the 20 years. So this is a big toy. You know, it's going to be a big toy. So you're definitely going in December. That's awesome. That's awesome. There's a guy from Maryland I think you're going to like a lot. He's my friend Peter. You know, I think you'll get along with him well. So let's see. Oh, here. I'll do one. Let's do one. Yeah. One more. I think I'm going to stop after this. I might hang out for a couple more minutes, but. Oh, is Bisco Lou here? Is he in travel or something today? He's been a little MIA for the last month. Not as MIA as Punkin, but he's been a little MIA. He'll probably, I think he doesn't like us. I think he likes us. I think he's just, I think this is his that he wants. I might be confusing him with my other buddy. This hat? I've got a hat in the, you think so? No, Bisco Lou's been chatting recently. He's been chatting recently. I've seen him. He's just on at different times. He misses us, and we miss him. Like, we're all, like, I miss you guys, and you guys, like, I'm basically the one who misses everybody, but. I can't, for some reason, it won't let me pop it up, but it's a, I have the white one. I only have white ones. I don't know. I'm sure you've seen me with it on, but it's that one. But you don't feel obligated to buy it either. And next time you, if you want, next time you buy a, you know, buy a, if you want a, next time you get a Simpsons figure, I'll throw one in probably. So, but if anybody else wants one, who isn't planning on buying a Simpsons figure, let's see. Oops. The Gamorrean Guard is one of the more like is one of the bigger you know, one of the bigger Star Wars figures, and I think it's actually my buddy Robert who wanted this. I don't think it was Bisco Lou. I think he wanted the job. Bisco likes the Jawas. My buddy Robert likes the Gamorrean Guard, so the white ones are great. Has the Nintendo? Yeah. Did I give you a white hat already to me? I feel like I might have. These are uncirculated again. Gamorrean Guard. I love the original trilogy. So this is the original trilogy release. They have the very traditional Star Wars. You know, back with like the trilogy down here. This is when the first three come out. Yeah, no problem. I'm gonna do a raid anyway, I think, pretty soon here. So all good, VT. Yeah, thanks again. And let me know what size t-shirt to send you, and I'll get it out, in the next week. So I don't send stuff super fast, guys, but I do get it out within a week. Yeah, I've got a bunch of stuff for sale if anybody wants anything. But if anybody has any more questions before we raid somebody, I'm happy to answer questions or do whatever. You know what? Let me do one last giveaway, and then I'll do a giveaway, and then we'll go raid somebody. If anybody wants anything, let me know. Goldfoil 13. Follow me and get on some payment plans, man. So I miss you already too. I miss you too, Niglas. So I tell everybody it's about just trading. Like, you gotta get into stuff and then sell that and get into better stuff. and then sell that and get into better stuff. It's all about getting into stuff that has more value, right? And, you know, getting trading that to get more, right? You want to get like I offer great deals. Like if you buy something from me, theoretically, you should be able to, like, maybe not in a day, but within a nice time frame, get some percentage of, like, return on that and go spend that on something where, again, that you get a better, you know, that you're getting cheaper than what the market's at. So, you know, a lot of people are impatient about this. A lot of people want to do it quickly. If there was a way for me to buy something today and sell it for 20% tomorrow and do that every single day, I'm going to do that all the time, every day, in huge volumes. There's not a way to do that. There's not. And so you have to buy well, and you buy stuff under market value, and then find the right buyer when you're ready to move on. But find stuff that you like. If you find stuff that you like, other people like it too, I'll bet you. And if you get stuff that's, you know, high quality, look, like this. This is not an expensive toy right now. This is probably going to be about $250, maybe $300, but probably about $250. I'll run it right now for $250 if someone wants it. But, like, you know, this is an 85 uncirculated Star Wars, right? You hold this for a year, right? Star Wars tends to do really, really well, especially high grade collectibles. This is uncirculated, and it's going to be 2004. So 2024, this is going to be considered vintage all of a sudden. So what do you think the value of this might do? Even if in a year, let's say in a year you get 20% more than what you paid for it, right? That's beat every stock you could possibly own. No stock is returning 20% year on year. So you buy this and sell this for 20% more next year, you've outpaced every market metric that you could possibly be. Do you have any graded Family Guy? No, not at the time. You know, it might be something that I pick up quite great, but it really depends on prices. I got to be able to pick up stuff that I can still give to you at such great prices that, like, we both win, right? And I take losses on some stuff to do that, but, like, you know, but I got to be able, you know, I got to be able to give it to you and not lose my ass. Let's put it that way. Like, so, but, you know, stuff like this, I'd keep all this stuff. I'd keep this, I'd sit on this for 5 years. Cause I guarantee in 5 years, this is going to be worth a lot of money. 2004, uncirculated. You can't get them uncirculated in the future because they have to come out of cases. Once they come out of cases and people are taking these out of cases now and selling them, you know, if they find them at all, you know, and so, They get sold, they get put up on walls, they get tacked up, they get destroyed, right? This is one that's been preserved already with a high grade and the uncirculated tag. That's where you want to be. You want to get these now while they're dirt cheap, you know, compared to where they're going. You know, $250 now might be $1,000 in 2 years. Again, I can't tell you the future 100%, but, like, collectibles like this tend to outpace the market. That's what I can tell you. Yeah, I mean, listen, but even if you find this, right, if you find this at a garage sale, you still got to pay $125 to grade this. And you got to take the time. And then if you grade it and it doesn't get an 85 uncirculated, you know, it won't get uncirculated. And if it doesn't get an 85, you basically just wasted your money. Like, if this comes back a 75, no one wants this card in a 75. You know, maybe it's worth $100, $125 because covers the you can only get them uncirculated from shipper crates. That means they have to go straight from here to the graders. That's the only way that the AFA will market is uncirculated, if it came straight from a shipper crate. So, you know, there's definitely some value in this, but staying ahead of the market. What I was getting to before, guys, this is the giveaway, by the way. What I was getting to before is a lot of people like to just turn stuff over really quick. And if you turn stuff over really quick, you never get investment value to it. You never get investment value. You're never going to get rich. You're never going to get rich like that. So, but, you know, you're never going to get rich by not holding. If you turn stuff over right away, you have to do incredibly high volumes. You'll never get rich that way. You have to have an investment arm to your portfolio. You have to. You have to. You will never become wealthy off trading day over day. Day trading is exceptionally hard, and you have to have such a huge bankroll to do it. It's not the way to get rich. For literally 99.999% of people are not going to get rich by trading. You'll get rich through trading, but you'll get rid the mechanism that you'll get rich through is the investment, where the day trading, you can't day trade. It's got to be an investment. So that's why I do payment plans. That's why I do what I do, to help you get into that. So you have vintage Disney and Toy Stories from the 90s. If it's sealed, maybe. If it's not sealed, you'll get, you can sell them on whatnot all day for, $5-$10, I guess. I don't know, $2. I honestly don't know, that kind of market as well. I prefer not to. I don't think if it's not sealed, I don't like stuff that's not sealed in general. I think if you have a rule that stuff has to be sealed, I think you ultimately raise your chances of getting a return on investment by a very large percentage. And maybe you miss a couple things that you could have made money on by having it unsealed, but like, most of the unsealed stuff, I think, ultimately gets called junk investments. Like, I don't think those are where the money are, personally. So, definitely follow me on Instagram for more stuff. I'm going to be sending out a newsletter probably tonight. So check me out on Instagram, and check me out on Instagram. I'll probably do my newsletter this week. Probably tonight, actually. So lots of market insight and stuff like that. But I appreciate you guys. If anybody has any last requests, let me know. Otherwise, why don't we go raid EDC plug? Love, Tyler. So, or should we raid Envy Coin? Envy Coin, I do have a graded Bart, but it's going to be more money, dude. You want to? I'll show it to you real quick. You want to see graded Bart? There's the graded bar. I love that. It's the same and crazy, really. This applies to numismatics too. It applies to every market. If you don't have a buy and hold strategy, you'll never get rich. You just won't. Anybody who turns over inventory in a single day, you might make money, but you'll never get rich that way. You'll never get rich. You have to have some old pieces. You have to, and you have to strike. You have to buy low. When the market itself is low, you have to buy. And when the market itself improves, that's when you sell. And you need things that outpace the market. So the market, if the S&P is up 10%, you want something that's going to be up 100%. And that's where collectibles come into play. So, oh, man, dude, I don't even know an 85 on this. It's such a... Honestly, I wasn't even sure about selling it. I probably would want. I'd give you a better deal, but I would, honestly, I probably would put this up for at least $650 on eBay, because it's an 85, and this is exactly the investment that you want. I mean, this is the exact investment you want, right? It's Bart Simpson. It's an 85. I mean, I'd do better for you if you want to, it's one that I could sit on forever. You know what I mean? Like, this is exactly, I do. Not Bart's though. I got Simpsons, but not Bart. Okay. Let's see. What was the one?
I think the one that just came in, maybe.
Maybe I'll do that for you.
Which we're just, all right, you know what? Fuck it.
This one just came in. I'll do this one for you if you want. Man, this should be more, but Coin Crate always hooks me up too. If anybody wants a bid, I'd appreciate it, but sorry, Coin Crate, I'm just saying. I'll start it where you ask. The lady's it's Skinner, Agnes Skinner. So this is Seymour. So the principal Skinner's. This is Principal Skinner's mom. You don't know Agnes Skinner? This is the principal's mom. So I had this at over 200 to start, but you know, if you want it, it's running, by the way, if you want it. Definitely no pressure. But Coin Crate in. I was gonna even at a deal, I was gonna start at 175, and I'm like, he asked for 150. I'm just I'll throw it in half for you for sure. Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, that's a good deal, bro. Like I said, it's $125 to grade these. So, you know, it's you basically got the figure and all the time, everything done, you know, included. So it's a good one. I hope you know this character. This is, I love this one. There's a playset. Absolutely, bro. I appreciate you. I'll definitely throw in a hat for you. I would definitely be honored if you would rep it. That would be the best. So I appreciate you very much. All right, let's do another giveaway, and then we'll go Ray Tyler. Giveaway and then Tyler? Is that okay? Yes. Yes, you absolutely can, Felicia Kitty Mama. I do a lot of new stuff all the time. I don't have anything on my story right now. I'm slacking. This was from Heritage the other night. Heritage auction I covered. The link was in my story. It's also on my let's see. The link is in this in the description here. If you want to, the YouTube.com DRob Gaming at DRob Gaming, that will give you all my videos, including this most recent one where I covered the Heritage auction. Ectoplasm. There's my Halloween costume. Thundercats. Turtles. Star Wars. Zelda. Money, Shredder, VHS, all kinds of stuff, guys. There's a killer ancient I got from Antiquity Coin. Gonna take to Orlando to get graded. Here's a Scrooge McDuck gold coin. Really, really cool. Evil Inn, an Elvis ticket, 1971 Elvis ticket. Some big, big games. Bunch of stuff comes in on Thursdays and days like today. This was like 1 or 2 weeks of accumulation. So that's why it gets to be a lot for me. So I try to do it on here, but, you know, it gets to be a lot. So we try to do what we can, but it's a lot. It's a lot. So I sold this guy a while ago. Imperial Stormtrooper, you know, gave a great deal on that. Some funny stuff. I just got these in. These are in right now. You turn off the lights and they glow. Let's see. There you go. All right. Alexa, louder. So that's what we're doing, guys. Follow me on Instagram. Make me offers on stuff. Like, I give great deals. I give payment plans. And
try to help everybody get into stuff that you want to get into. So get into the investments that are going to help you for tomorrow, going to put your kid through college. So that's what it's about, man. It's about putting some money aside, and that's what this is. It's investing. You're investing in your future. I could have been a financial advisor. I was a certified financial representative for 15 years. I was, so I know a little bit about this. One more dance, and I'm like, yeah, how the hell am I supposed to know? From a 120, I'm a certified 8.3. I don't know what that means. It is. I had an offer on another one of my gold notes. Where's my other gold cert? This is super, super fun. I need to take this to I need to take this to get graded. This should be about a $900 note in this kind of condition, and it's got a super fine serial number. Super, super clean. Yeah, this needs to go to grading. It needs to go to PMG. I'm open. I'll make it. If you want me to make an offer on it, I will. But it's a more expensive note. I do have another gold cert here that's a little bit less than that, but still expensive. Yeah, I don't know where I put it though. And stuff like that. Oh, Jameson. Oh, shit. All right, guys. Thank you for coming. Do AFAs get faked at all? Not to know. It's actually pretty. Yeah, it's a new Trump. Yeah. Let's see. I'm sorry. Yeah. All right. Anyway, thank you. I will see you guys soon. Appreciate you guys.